The 2015 ITM Comp is proudly brought to you by the TUI Brewery. Welcome to the second of the triple header on Sky Sports, a Super Saturday. Two sides have had mixed fortunes, but certainly are improving with every match. And these two sides first played in 1925, and from the 65 encounters, the clashes have always been high scoring, high drama, and high risk. Kia ora and good afternoon, everyone. It's Bay of Plenty hosting Taranaki at the Rotorua International Stadium. A healthy crowd starting to make their way into this magnificent stadium. It's September, which means spring has finally arrived. And speaking of arrived, defending Premiership champions Taranaki came into the game with three losses but have won their last two matches against Counties Manukau and Northland. A clinical tight five with pace in the back row. Captain Charlie Nartai has had an exceptional 2015, and his combination with Tamani Valo is returning to the form that made them a formidable force last year. A strong bench with both experience and Hicker Elliott and youth and New Zealand under 20 rep Sean Wainui in jersey 23. Joined in commentary by former All Black prop Bull Allen. And Bull, third venue for Bay of Plenty. Is this really home advantage?
Well, speaking to some of the locals during the curtain raiser, they would still like to see the games played here. Lots of people have fond memories of this ground, and they think it's still a place to play.
Well, I know your son was involved in that under-19 match as well. And Bay of Plenty, they last week showed tremendous will to win against Counties Manukau. And they'll be looking for their first back-to-back win in 2015. Nathan Harris continues to show glimpses of what made him an All Black last year. And Solomona Sakalia gets a start in his Blazer game. Dan Hollingshead starts again in that number 10 shirt. Good strong bench as well. And it's been a beautiful day over the North Island. Sideline for us is former All Black and Waikato man Matthew Cooper. Matt, have you got the beanie on?
Yes, I have, and I think I need it too, because it's going to drop down to about 2 degrees tonight here. Beautiful day, as you mentioned. Ground in great conditions. We've just seen the New Zealand Sevens beat the Australians on a hit-out in terms of a training hit-out. That was brilliant. So looking forward to it, Willie. Bay of Plenty will kick off from right to left on your screen. And this is a very important game for both sides in different leagues.
Really is, as Charlie Nartai leads out. Tamani Valu in behind him. Two wins for the former Premiership champions, and it's a long walk along there as before they make their way out onto the field. Good response as well from this very vocal crowd. And Blake Thompson, 35 carries, 117 metres, 5 offloads. The 24-year-old has been in great form in 2015. The man from the Tukapa Club, 30 line-out catches, and he's stolen a couple as well. Having a tremendous season, and Hohepa Te Toiroa, Tau Reorangi, product out of the Rotorua Boys High School. Important member of this year's Rugby World Championship under-20s in Italy. And his speed and accuracy and pairing in combination with Cody Ray should be a real feature tonight as the hosts. So important for Bay of Plenty in this game.
Yeah, they've had a good season. They've won three so far this year, but they're in the big league today. And Taranaki, as we know, they started slowly, but they're starting to fight a bit of momentum.
And the kids, it's been club day, and so all the kids were there alongside. And a big moment too for Pingi Talaapitanga, the 28-year-old, 100K tight head prop. Over 30 games for Bay of Plenty, 312 minutes this year, 21 carries, an offload. And Bull, he's been responsible for two try assists.
Yeah, he's done some great stuff this year. He's very constructive when he gets the ball in hands. And time on the field would indicate he's a very big part of this Bay of Plenty machine.
And the referee for today is Angus Mabey. And Abel Tihau Itaiatini, the man from the Te Kura Kaupapa Māori or Rotoiti. And Rotoiti is his club as well. And what a moment for the young 13-year-old to bring the ball out. A wonderful innovation that they brought in 2015. Bull, I love it.
Oh, it's fantastic. It gives a young man like this his moment in the sun, and you can just tell every time one of these young boys brings the ball on how much it means to them. Big smiles on their face, and a lot of cases giving the ball to their heroes.
Well, he'll take the sticker back to his school because, of course, ITM running a competition with $10,000 worth of DIY to give away to some lucky schools. And no doubt his ball counts. Bay of Plenty to kick off. Dan Hollingshead with a high kick. Thompson takes it down beautifully just outside his own 22, and they rumble forward through Halafihi. Tanafau had to play. Tavao had to play halfback there, and they get it to Hall. And so Taranaki with the dark shorts and black. Charlie Nartai looks for some field position. Hollingshead in a good positional play, looks, and then he decides to unleash the ball. That's it. Craft Chemist with his first touch of the ball, and he's done well to get up and over the advantage line easily. Tolma looks and gets it out. Bay of Plenty come on the attack. Some of those jerseys look a little bit similar, but the black and white shorts are the difference, and Bay of Plenty now in possession.
Hold here, Black.
Tolma again looks at both options, and then here's the first five. So here come Bay of Plenty on the attack again. The referee says incorrect entry from Retallick. First penalty of the game to Taranaki.
Yeah, I like the start from both teams. It looked like they're going to move it around, and it's perfect conditions down there. I spent a bit of time sideline earlier, and Coops will be enjoying it down there, even though it's a little bit fresh. But perfect conditions for the game today.
Oh, absolutely, and I think also the wind as well. There's Taranaki would have kicked into what breeze there is at the moment. Not bad. Here's the carry here. They were very good in Pukekohe, the forwards. They got very physical. And that's been impressed me in the last couple of weeks with the Bay. They've got the entry there was incorrect, and a chance for Taranaki to launch an attack.
I like the jerseys, Willie. Taranaki jerseys with the bull on the front. Yeah. Sharp.
I knew you would. I was waiting for you to comment on them. And you'd be pleased with the way that Tavo has started this game as well, carting it forward. Now Thompson goes one off the ruck. Tahuri Orangi gets him quickly. Good service with the ball a little high for Tamani Valley. They brought it down. Halafihi's done very well to hold on to the ball and stay in play. Tava puts his shoulder to the wheel and carts it forward again. They go one way left and then one way right. They're using Tamani Valley, bringing him close into the ruck, knowing how dangerous he is. And the hands are up, saying, here, I'll carry. And that's Marshall. Reese Marshall. Six phases. Now they look to the back line. Cody Ray tries to get on the outside of Hollingshead. Can't do it.
No hands.
Tauri Orangi. It's Tavao again. Running like a loose forward. Holds the ball up. Places it. Tauri Orangi. The quick release here. They get it out to Orman. Jackson Orman.
Come on.
They have to fight to try and stay in, and he can't.
Easy, boys. Cool heads. Three. Leave it.
Bit of early feeling in there, Willie. There's a little bit of a silent pause as we're deciding who's going to say what. Easy meters there from Taranaki. Very effective. Tarvel, as you mentioned, just those one-off runners, so Bay are going to have to be very wary of that.
And down to Tia Tia. They've decided to try and get it out of their danger zone. Bay of Plenty, that's their try line. You can see Tolma gets in and gets it back to Chase. Tia Tia, who's got a lovely left foot. And he clears the danger zone, moves it out 26 away from the goal line.
Tietia, one of the better players in the ITM Cup early. The winger there for Bay of Plenty. Very accurate. He's a good finisher. And that's again, though, Taranaki doing well at line-out time and scrum time in this competition, as you'd expect from the defending champions.
Well, Coops, Tietia's handy, isn't he? Because he gives you that left field option, doesn't he? And your left and right foot, so it's good depending what part of the field you're on.
Huiata goes high. Now they look to set a platform in the midfield through Hall. Quickly recycled. Ray gets it out to Tamani Valu. The missed pass. Here out to Vainu. Couldn't hold on to the ball, though. Vainu, and now Bay of Plenty. We'll look to just kick the ball and find some territory and space. It's rolling, it's rolling. And it's a great clearance. Wow, what a kick.
Yeah, fantastic stuff there from Caleb Hall, but it all started here. They're looking dangerous on the outside in the defence there. I think it was the fullback, Tarangi Fraser, dislodge the ball, and Hall's able to make some great meters for his team. Reece Marshall with the third throw for Taranaki. They go high and they bring it down to Hoyata as well. So the lineout's working well for the defending champions. Tarvale standing out at first five says, I'll go forward again.
He's a one-man wrecking machine at the moment.
He is. Now back to Natai, who looks for some space. Fraser is there. Terangi Fraser brings the ball back and then tries to kick. It's gone deep inside the 22. How's the bounce? Well, it's a good bounce because it didn't go dead. And it's been charged down. They're all onside. And Tahu Reorangi gets his hands on the ball and he gets the attention of one of the Bay players at the same time. It was 9-on-9, so great tackle from Toma. Bay of Plenty with the ball inside the Taranaki 22. Toma goes in. So the charge down has worked well for the hosts. And Talapatanga cuts it forward. Now they get it out to Kipa Mure. Standing just a couple wide. All hands on the pump now for Taranaki, defending the five out from their try line. The pick can go from the forwards. That was up to Edu that had it earlier on, but Thomas got it now. And there is an advantage to Bay of Plenty.
No advantage, two offside.
The charge down really worked for them, and Bay of Plenty are building phases nicely.
Well, tit for tat, didn't it? Taranaki were doing it down the other end of the field. Bay of Plenty come back and doing some nice work, setting their phases up and being accurate. That's the key to it. You can take it up, but you've got to be accurate. And here we see the charge down from Ray, and it was Fraser, I think, he got his hands on it. And this is where they built pressure, but two players offside there, one of them being Reece Marshall, and Angus Mabey, he was all over it.
Good little start too from Toma, the halfback for Bay of Plenty. Big defence as well. But what I like, Willie Lowe say, the likes of these, have a look at these loose forwards from the Bay of Plenty, the likes of Tupe, Honick, and particularly Sean Uru, the big number six. He's starting to really enjoy playing at this level.
Yeah, my apologies. It was actually Edu earlier, not Mewitt, that carted it forward. And here is Dan Hollinshead, 85%, 11 from 15 in 2015. Looking to try and take his tally up to 30 points. And the hosts score first. That will please the crowd here.
Yes, absolutely. Dan Hollinshead, he's playing well. He had to fight a bit to get in the starting lineup. The man's only 20. He's a young man, and look at him. He looks like a seasoned pro in a second season of ITM Cup.
Got a good mentor too, David Hill. He's looking after the goal kickers, looking after the first fives here over in the Bay.
And what a classy player David Hill was in his time. So they certainly have got the pedigree. And more importantly, they have the lead. Ball may have been lost forward there from Fokiti, I think it was.
Oh, time to get excited. Willie and Cooks, first scrum.
Well, this is interesting, though. You know, just in terms of the research which I've done, which I'm sure you've done as well, Bill. Scrum time, 93% is success rate, the Taranaki scrum. Bay of Plenty, only 73%. So this has been an issue for Clayton McMillan's men.
Yeah, they have struggled. They've creaked a little bit at times. So this Taranaki, they've got a pretty good scrum. We saw them get a pushover try in their last game. Very effective. So it's going to be a great contest. And as we know, you do the graft up front, the rest comes.
Steady.
Te Toiroa. Tahu Reorangi, beautiful surname, and he was in tremendous form. He pinches a few metres down the sideline. Tahu Reorangi looked for his winger. He hadn't read the play.
Hold here.
And now Taranaki. Good, solid set. They go, and Hall gets it out to Hoyata. Draws in two or three defenders. Ball comes back slowly. They pick and go again. Benny Hall, he's got his hands on the ball. Number of times the upper side flanker. And they pick and go again. Marshall goes one wider. That's where there seems to be a gap. Now the forwards look interested. Tahu Reorangi gets it out to Ray. Ray along the line to Nath Gatai. A pass on the infield there. Just couldn't go to hand. The Bay of 20 backs were offside.
13.
The Taranaki forward packs getting into their work early. They look so polished, don't they? They've got a real understanding of what each other's doing. They know their roles. I was talking to Colin Cooper before the game, and he said, "But a great bunch of guys are really starting to come together well." But it all started the scrum. Tahu Reorangi, well, he's a Rotorua Boys High School. That's where he's from. He's from here. So he'll be looking to fire up today.
And this is nice play. They had the numbers, but Bay of Plenty were offside, so...
Well, it was a good scrum. It was a good scrum from both sides there, but it looked as though Sean Uru, he was putting a lot of effort on, and he forgot this very quick halfback, Tahuri Orangi, this, as Willie Lose's already mentioned. Geez, he's explosive.
It's a shame his winger wasn't there, because it could have been interesting, but Cody Ray with his first penalty, and we're all tied up. Three apiece, 10 gone in the first half of this match, and a healthy crowd in here as well, you've got to say. They love their footy in Rotorua.
Oh, it's wonderful. There's a wonderful crowd here. The ground is absolutely mint. I've watched a couple of games here. I've watched a women's under-18 game. I've watched an under-19 game and a sevens game today, all on this ground. And look at it. It's magic.
Speaking of magic, Thompson goes high again and plucks the ball down. Halafihi manages to control it. And so Taranaki, they'll try and get the ball out of their danger zone. Baker comes up and there's the missed pass from Ngātai to Tamani Vali running across the field, and now he straightens it up through Bonu, but he's got a case of the whoopsies because that's the second time the left winger has dropped it cold. Small advantage here for the Bay of Plenty. If they can use it, here's Fraser, Tenangi Fraser gets the attention from Marshall, puts a shot on him, bounces out of it, and they go again, this time through Metallic. Toma goes in, advantage might be over now. As Craft Chemist comes looking for some work in close to the ruck. Here's Fokiti. They're trying to hold him up and drive him towards the touchline. He's done well to fight to get his way to the ground in the tackle of Charlie Ngātai. Holland's head. Big deep pass to Fraser. Now the advantage is over, and here comes Tiatia. Chase Tiatia. Draws the attention, but then he throws the ball straight to Mitchell Croswell. And Baker says, let's get out of here and let's play the game. Inside their 22, that might be too far, and it is. We'll come back from where he kicked it. That was around 12 metres inside his own half. And that breeze, Matt Cooper, I thought it was favouring Bay of Plenty, but is it just swirling at the moment?
No, I think it's really just died right down, Willie, and turning into a beautiful night, albeit a little bit fresh. There's the old flat ball there, just chasing Tiatia, just showing you, doesn't he, just that little bit. He's always going to offer something, isn't he, on attack. Good play from Taranaki. Unfortunate there for the Taranaki fullback, right option. Just ticked, overcooked it a little bit.
An interesting stat to note, Willie. So far in this match, there has been no turnovers or breakdown. That shows you how polished both teams are and how accurate they've been so far in this game. Brilliant, isn't it?
Just early signs, just Taranaki, when they got ball in hand, just look a little bit more clinical to me. But it's as I say, very early days. Bay of Plenty, they've got a lot of ticker. There's a lot of resolve in the side this year.
I wouldn't want to put my lunch money on either side at this stage, Coops.
I like the way they're using Tamani Valu a little bit wider as well. He's a real threat. There's the Taranaki centre as Toma goes in and clears it. Hollingshead with the running ball. Just pops it up and asks Caleb Hall to cut it forward. Does well, this smallish second 5'8". Hollingshead is met by the loose forward trio of Hall and Croswell. Toma goes in, they go the same way. And here is Edu.
6-2 slide. No. 6-2 slide. 6-2 slide. You were fine, but too slow from 6. Shot. Shot here.
Well, you heard it there. Too slow in the breakdown getting away.
Look at that stat though, Bull. Best breakdown turnover record in the ITM Cup. 29 to Bay of Plenty.
Well, that's outstanding. That's talks of a forward pack who works hard. Here we see in the setup there, and it's Croswell. Yeah, he's in no panic to get away from that. Deemed by the referee. Hall's not happy.
He doesn't muck around, Dan Hollingshead. Here he is, about 38 metres out. Hometown kicker, good player.
It's a high percentage in 2015 of 85. He's one from one. He looks to try and
down the middle.
There you heard it first from Matthew Cooper. Straight down the middle. I suppose he turned and started running straight back, Matt.
Yeah, I got up too and started turning.
Which is always a bit of a struggle as we get older. To turn at pace, that is. What's the don't atmosphere?
Forget,
what's the atmosphere?
Oh, sorry. Yeah, don't forget Rugby World Cup pop-up channel. First to the 18th of September. It's been replaying a number of the matches. And another mistake from Bay of Plenty. When they scored before, they made the error of losing it, and they've done that again.
It's a concentration thing, isn't it? How often you see a team score and the other team kicks off and the team makes an error. You've just got to really keep on your mantle and keep that concentration going. Little errors like this, they can really swing games around the wrong way for you.
Yeah, keep an eye on those two, Charlie Nartai and Seta Tamanivalu. I'm already seeing him. Had a bit of a quiet Super Rugby season for the Chiefs. Didn't really get his opportunity. This guy can really light up a game.
Well, he brought the ITM Cup to life in 2014. Was the player of the tournament, without a doubt. And it was interesting too. Matt Cooper and Bill Allen, that he certainly got the attention of the All Black selectors. Good solid scrum, Tahuri Orangi to right. Well, he had Tamanivalu there, so gap appeared and the ball is slow coming back. They've picked and gone again. Great work coming in from one of the locks, and now Ray again has to cart the ball forward. Tahuri Orangi looks left, looks right, tells them to come out to the right. And that's where they do go out to Hoyata. Ricky Hoyata in jersey 4. Marshall carts it forward. Now, no panic here from Chinonaki. Just beating the phases nicely. They go left, then they go right, and then they come out to Thompson. So explosive. There's the big lock. Got through the gap there. And now it's out to Croswell. Heading towards the midfield. Tarvel standing at first receiver, releases the ball to his captain and Charlie Nartai. Good tackle there coming in from Sakalia. And now Tamanivalu gets it out to Vianu. Just too short, he may have lost it forward as he went to ground. They pick and go, here's Tarvel again. Now just a metre short, Tahuri Orangi out the back door to Ray. Ray throws it along the ground. That needed to go to hand. That's the pass, that's the Hail Mary out. Where Ormond is standing, now the pass on the inside. Thompson goes close, the pop pass, Nartai's over, Nartai scores. He's got to keep them guessing and waiting a little longer as he goes to the TMO.
Could be a knock on, you're checking TMO further back.
Grant, just want a potential knock on from Black 6 in the lead up to that try, please. On about the 22.
Thought it had happened as well, and they may have missed it, so we'll get a chance to see exactly what happened. I thought it was out towards the left-hand touch side. They said that they were looking for a knock-on out towards where the 22 was, so yeah, it is along the ground. Croswell, has he knocked it on? Bull?
Oh, gee, that's a toughie. It certainly moved from his hand to the ground, didn't it? Whether that was directly down or forward, let's have another look. Oh, wow. Gee, that's a toughie. I would say yes.
Knock on?
Yes.
Matthew Cooper? Well, you can't give an opinion because he's stolen your
Well, I am.
Position.
I can. I'm way over the other side now looking at the big screen, and I'm going to say no.
Here we go.
All right, I'll have the casting vote, and I'm 100% at the moment. Everything I say is wrong, so I'll go try.
Yes. I believe there's a knock-on from Black 6.
Yeah, it has been propelled forward.
Thank you.
You were right, spot on, Bull.
No try.
I'm stoked. It's the first one I've got right in three games. You beauty.
That's good officiating, and that's good use of the technology that we've got available, because he could have just looked at the grounding or something else, but he wanted to go all the way back, and that's good.
Oh, I like that. Quite frankly, I thought that was a try initially. I didn't even see the knock-on. I just sort of went down and carried on, and I like the way he just slowed it down. If you've got the technology, use it. Some nice skills here, though. Look at Thompson. Just scoot that up, and you're talking about this Taranaki midfield backs. Nartai, how good's he been this year? He just pops up in all the right places.
New Zealand Māori captain. He led them well. In 2015, he is a class player. Bay of Plenty now have the opportunity to get out of their own 22. The big scrum comes on, and they've done it well, effectively. And it's a ball who's just going to cart it forward. He's so good at that. In the close contact areas of just carting the ball forward, and now that allows Hollingshead the chance to get back inside his 22. Offloads to Tirangi Fraser.
Just a bit quick, well.
I'll just go back to Angus Mabey there too, Willie, in terms of the decision. Shane McDermott told him there is something we need to look at, and the referee just said, no, let's play that out. And I really like that referee. And he just let it go. He knew that he can always come back and use technology. Good play from the young referee.
Just where you are, Tim.
He's doing a good job. He's doing a wonderful job tonight, Angus Mabey. He looks calm and in control, and that's what it's all about. And the communication's nice and direct and clear. Beautiful.
I saw him earlier at the hotel. We were both staying at the same hotel. He looked very calm just sitting there with the other officials. And that's what you want from a referee.
Sure, you'll be pretty calm later on at night too, Willie.
Straight to bed tonight, Matthew. Nathan Harris there from the Bay of Plenty. You can see them playing in the light white shorts up against Taranaki in the dark shorts. Hollinshead has the ball. The right winger comes looking for some work. Craft Chemist, they get it out to Fraser. Te Rangi Fraser, not much of him. And he's lost the ball. Baker gets it out in the midfield where Vainu had come across from the left wing. He's not known for his kicking, and that's the reason why.
Well, that's first incursion of Te Rangi Fraser. He's had a very good start as well. The young fullback, as Willie Lose mentioned, he's pretty slight of build, but he just has that ability to break that first tackle.
And they carried it back as well. So, real turn of fortunes for the hosts, Bay of Plenty. After almost conceding a try, they've gone 75 metres.
Well, they haven't seen the grass that often in this part of town, so they'd be pretty happy.
How's the line out? It's working well. They bring it down. Sakalia holds on to it. They look to reset through Tupe, who has it now at the back. They've come through the middle, and Tupe has to break away. Well, they rolled about three times. And I think he kept rolling because he had lost control of the ball. So tremendous defensive work from Mitchell Graham.
Tell you what, we've got a good set of hookers here this evening at Rotorua International Stadium. We've got Nathan Harris, Reece Marshall, probably battling on for a chief spot, aren't they, at the moment? And in the reserves, Joe Royal and Hicker Elliott. So four very good hookers here on display.
Yeah, all the top four hookers in the Chiefs area for sure. I just love the energy at the moment of the Taranaki team. We're just picking up in our ears here. They just a lot of positive talk, really encouraging each other and high energy levels. And there's Hicker Elliott, a little bit aggrieved not to be going to the World Cup. I thought he was right in contention myself. I think he's had an absolutely storming season. And isn't it great to see a guy, he had a serious neck injury, prolapsed disc, I believe, and he's fought back and come back as a better player. Wonderful, wonderful story.
Stand up.
Well, there are a number of heartbreak stories of the players that have been left behind, but there's no doubt, and if there are injuries, they won't lose too much, the All Blacks, and the quality of players that are left behind to play ITM Cup, and it's much better that they're here playing in our domestic competition instead of being at some hotel in the Northern Hemisphere.
Well, the other thing is, too, what I like about the players that have been left behind, they're fronting up in the ITM Cup and passing on that experience to the players around them. That's wonderful.
Saw that from Sifuanga in that match against Waikato last night. What a difference he made to that Southland side. As Taranaki, the defensive scrum. Ngātai comes into first receiver, runs into Hollinshead. Can't get away from the first five. Sets the ball, Tahuria Rangi. Now we'll look to clear it. Lovely high kick to Tiatia, who sees it. Brings it down and gives it to Fraser. Fraser wants to move it on. This is good back play from the Bay of Plenty. Craft Chemist had a second five and centre who dropped back brilliantly to that right-hand side, and now they get it into the concrete mixes in the middle. Tiatia quickly releases it. Now here is Marshall. It's Mewis on the left-hand side. No hands, says the ref. Was actually Iru standing out here. There is Ritalik playing second receiver. And they ask him a lot. Goes into contact, here's Fraser. Won't go past Tama Nivalu. So plenty of ball movement from Bay of Plenty, but not too much south-north. They seem to be going more east and west. And so Hollinshead just puts his head down and goes forward. Now, Ritalik will have to go forward. Instead of distributing, that's what they do. Tight forwards are there to support. Tama gets it out to Fokiti. There's a big Taranaki wall in front of him. Now the forwards get interested and start rumbling forward here. Toma has the ball, has some options. coming up and getting interested is Tirangi Fraser at first receiver. Takes a great shot. And one of the Taranaki forwards who then infringes again.
Must support your own body weight. Must support your own body
I think that that's Benny Hall again. And Taranaki's won the last seven matches between these two sides.
Yeah, she's 2006, Willie. 9 years ago was their last win. 2016 over at the Mount was the Bay's last win as Hollingshead goes for goal. Like this passage of play ball, they just kept very patient, didn't they? They weren't going ahead. It actually took Hollingshead to actually say, we've got to try and get over the advantage line. But the good part about that phase play was the patience of the Steamers.
Yeah, they're doing some good stuff there, and the breakdowns are very accurate, both teams, as already mentioned. No turnovers and breakdowns still when we're over 20 minutes into the game, but they're committing numbers. Sometimes you see in modern rugby players not committing enough numbers, whereas what they're doing is they're assessing the situation as they see it, and if they need two, they hit two in there. If they need four, they hit four in there. I like it. They're playing smart rugby.
Hollingshead 100% in this match. Looks to extend the lead. No problem with the distance, the direction is out to the right. Taranaki with the dark shorts there to Kurt Baker. He takes it very quickly and gets it back now to Mitchell Croswell. He finds some open spaces and throws a lovely pass out the back door to Baker. Kurt Baker couldn't control it. It was charged down, knock-ons both ways.
What a ball from Mitchell Croswell. Beautiful passage of play from the blindside flanker. Just have a look at it now. He comes through in behind, over the top, the one-hander to set Kurt Baker away.
Oh, that was quality. That's worth watching a couple of times. Look at him. He's just teasing them. Nice skills. I think these two have played a bit of backyard rugby together. By the look of that combo, look pretty good.
Good player is Mitchell Croswell too. 52 tackles. He has made ahead of this game. Gets through his work, as does Mitchell Brown, who's a similar amount. And so good work rate, not only on defence, but also showing the skills there on attack.
Taranaki fullback Kurt Baker on the right hand side. Midfield scrum, you can see him there on the left with Jackson Orman. Easy way to go. They've got a good scrum. They've got a strong scrum, the visitors.
Hold here, nine.
And that looks like the way they want to go, and they do. Halafihi Tauri Orangi brings in Baker now. A lovely little short pass.
He's offside, he's in front. Was knocked on.
And it went forward to Ray.
Offside.
The gap was certainly there, but just the execution.
Well, they manipulated the Bay of Plenty defence. The only thing that was lacking was a final pass. It could have been big trouble for the Bay. Nicely worked move. Gee, there's been some practice put into that, I'd say.
Probably the message from Colin Cooper at halftime will be just that final pass, isn't it? This is a lovely little set play. Inside ball, you can see Cody coming over there. The first five there, Cody Ray. And if he'd gone through there, there was a nice little hole.
Colin Cooper, along with Willie Rickards, to the left of your screen.
Just to tell you how long Colin Cooper's been coaching, I haven't played rugby for about 17 years, but he coached me for Taranaki way back in about 96. So he's been involved a long time. He's a real brains trust when it comes to rugby.
Well, look at his CV. Super Rugby New Zealand, Māori as well. And he's been a terrific asset for the Taranaki region, but also for rugby in general. And Sakalea in his blazer game just holds on to the ball. Thompson said, did I come through the middle? The referee says, no, you didn't. So the arm comes out. There is an advantage, Toma, to Hollingshead. The grubber kick along the ground. Tiatia chases. He won't win the race because Orman gets there first, but they'll come back for the penalty.
Three entry.
Well, take a bow. The Bay of Plenty forwards, Clayton McMillan, you've brought some real resolve into the side in 2015. And then the nice little touch, Bull Allen. The little grubber through this, the option. Good little option from the first five.
It wasn't. And when you get in this situation, you've got to have your structure right. You've got to have your players in the front of you, in front of the ball, I should say, doing the work. And you can see they're doing that. The legs are driving, working hard. And it's a ploy that they used a heck of a lot last year. I think the front rows at one stage were the top try scorers for the Bay of Plenty, including Joe Royal.
Well, they've opted to go for the line out instead of the 3 points, which is interesting because that was an easier kick for Dan Hollingshead. They've got some momentum in this forward pack. Have some belief. Harris now with the throw. Retallick calls himself and he can't get it. And so Hall can't get there. Ormond has the ball. The right winger, and he's lost it forward there too.
Easy, boys.
Well, the decision, Bill, do you go along? Do you agree with the decision to go to the line out?
Oh, I like their confidence, but I'm always a great believer in taking points when they're on offer like that. That was a gift, really, the way Dan Holland's head kicks. He does the business, so yeah.
Don't forget Rooftop Rugby, the guests, Sally Williams and Sean Fitzpatrick from the Northern Hemisphere out of London, Saturday the 19th, 9:30. Sky Sport 1 as we count down to the Rugby World Cup of 2015. Can't wait.
Tarangi
Every
Fraser.
Live on Sky Sport.
Tarangi Fraser just in behind Hollingshead there. You can see him there, the fullback. He's a very good broken field player, broken field runner at the back. Got a lot of meters in this competition. Let's see what Taranaki do. Do they want to just let them know that we've got a pretty good scrum?
Yeah, scrum first, isn't it? That's the most important thing here. They've got it. And running ball, Toma gets it out to Fraser, who steps off the right, pops, and draws in the attention of the loose forwards. Now they pick and go through Tupi. They'll go again. Retallick's going to get his mitts on the ball. Ngātai comes through, and he's interfered with it. They pick and go again. The Bay of Plenty forwards, Toma. Lovely pass at the Hollingshead. They've got some players out here. That was Fraser again. Tenagi Fraser. And what are they going to do here? What's their decision? Oh, there's plenty of feeling out there from these two sides. That's what you expect in an ITM Cup match.
Charlie, offside. Offside.
Well, what an opportunity.
Time off.
You're playing against the defending champions from last year, the brilliant Taranaki side, and this Bay of Plenty team just building nicely. Got a pretty important fixture next week at McLean Park, Napier, and next Saturday against the Magpies.
Yeah, that's the battle for the Bay too, isn't it? World Cup Weekly, Monday the 21st at 8:30, Sky Sport 1. And a conversation here. That's where he says he was offside, so that's the infringement. And Angus maybe has gone all the way across to Shane McDermott. And he wants to have a chat. He wants to see something.
And potentially a blue player.
That may have been after the whistle had actually gone, because he was
about the 15-metre line.
A little bit of a hooey with some of the players. And so looking for Mitchell Croswell.
Did you see what six did?
He's asked the touch judge if he saw what he's done, and the touch judge says no, not really, just the end of it. This is what the TMO will be seeing and viewing. Yeah, they come in just there, swinging arm. He comes in. Has he made contact with Nathan Harris? I think the whistle had gone about there and he took exception to how Nathan Harris had come in.
I'm thinking yellow card, flat six.
It looks like an air swing from where I'm sitting. It's always the guy that retaliates that gets dealt to, though, doesn't he? Because Harris certainly appeared to take Croswell out from his blind side.
You got me there, Grant?
We'll hear what happens here.
Grant, can you hear me? You there? No. Yeah. Grant, I'll tell you what I've seen. I've seen black six clearly throw a punch.
They're connected with fresh air.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Charlie? Who's Charlie?
So,
Charlie. Could you bring black six to me?
Yeah. Come.
Bring back six to me, please.
That angle there is going to mean that Mitchell Croswell.
Unnecessary. It's clearly a punch, six. There's no place for that in the game. Where you go? Where you go?
You don't agree with the decision.
A reasonably positive game so far.
He's honest with his opinion as well. That's what you like.
Let's have a word. Let's keep the discipline and let's keep the positive attitude going. Is that clear? Thank you. Have a word. Time's off.
Obviously, in Taranaki. A push and a punch are different things than the referee Angus Baby considers to be a push and a punch in Auckland.
He's from Auckland, that's why.
Thank you.
you just haven't made any friends all of a sudden there, Willie.
Oh, wow. Let's be honest.
Look,
that wouldn't have parted the hair on Nathan Harris's chin, would it?
Not at all. Well, Willie and Bull, there's the second penalty they've turned down. That's about 6 points already. But they decide now, the number's down. Maybe it's that that rolling or driving ball, Bull Allen.
Well, they've got to get the line out right, because the last time they were in this position, they overthrew the ball. And so let's see if Vitalik can get it this time. They go long again and bring it down. There is Vitalik, who peels off and drives forward. They start complaining, saying that he's obstructed some players. Angus maybe will need worm cam to see if that ball was grounded.
Scrum 5 metre. I'm happy that it's held up.
Yeah. Scrum. Good luck finding where the ball is amongst that pile up. Well, Vitalik just broke away and just decided to go on his own there. You can see that Benny Hall is trying to hold him up. He's driving. Yeah, let's go to the scrum. No loose forward, so this is going to be an interesting decision as to how they play this.
Patience, gentlemen.
For the Bay of Plenty. And there is the man in the sin bin, Mitchell Croswell.
Let's go.
Well, the scrums have been an even contest so far, Willie. Obviously, when you're a man down, that changes things dramatically. So let's see if they have a crack. They've got no blindside flanker. And so that is where Joe Tupe should attack, because he'll get over the advantage line and he's only got a halfback to contest with.
Chase Tiatia just come across now as well.
Use it. Leave it.
They've got to use it.
Too deep in there. We'll go again.
Well, you're trying to promote that left side, aren't you, Boulder, if you want to use this blind side.
Yeah, absolutely. That's what they'll be looking to do. And Wembley Stadium, 3:45. Don't forget.
Oh, yes.
21st September, the All Blacks against Argentina. All of the matches of the 2015 Rugby World Cup, live and exclusive on Sky.
And hasn't it been wonderful, the replays on Sky of the old matches? Oh, it's been wonderful to watch. Just remembering players, you know, in their heyday. Oh, it's been so good. Enjoying every bit of it.
And all those scrums, you must have been loving it.
Scrums were a bit different in those days than some of those older matches.
Forward, the two props for the front rowers basically determine the cadence and how they sit. Another penalty.
On the arm, three. Must stay off his arm. Scrum.
Yeah, well, he's a crafty operator.
Go again, Willie Lose.
Off
they will.
Move this way slightly.
Yeah, right. Angus Tuivasa, he's just trying to slow it down, though. He's biding time.
Yeah.
Taranaki guilty of conceding a lot of penalties, 9-2. That's a pretty significant number.
Be a bit of a statement, too, if the home team can get across here. Obviously, it's the opportunity. You should try. Obviously, you've got to try and get the points up when you're going against 14.
Yeah, they've turned down two penalties that were in the kicking range of Dan Hollingshead. They went for the line out. They've now got a scrum. Can they get valuable points for the time that they've spent inside the Taranaki 22? Ball is out. Toma has to play at it. Tauri Orangi comes in. And now Taranaki have dodged a bullet brilliantly. Over the top they go. Tauri Orangi out to Ngātai. Tamanivalu looks interested in taking the ball to the line. Here he goes, the big man. Inside to Ngātai. Ngātai, Charlie Ngātai, just a fullback. He's trying to find some supporters here. Pops the ball up. Baker's there. Now they've got it to Vianu, inside to Tamanivalu. Oh, that would have been one of the great tries. It looks like it was carried back. I think this might be a try.
It could be a try.
I think it was a Bay of Plenty hand that knocked it back. And Latu Vianu has scored one of the great tries of 2015.
Well, so loosen up your replay lips, because this was a beauty. Outstanding.
The blue player. We'll have a check. Got me there, Grant. You're back in the frame. Oh,
Bay of Plenty, that scrum just went all wrong. And Tahu Kiarangi, he was the first man there, blew over. And then those Taranaki forwards, they just piled on there like there was no tomorrow. What commitment. Outstanding.
We won't get to see the big break from Tamanivalu and Charlie Ngātai. But it was just the last pass they're interested in.
Forward pass, round about the 22.
Okay, first of all, the forward pass.
The lead up into the try, please.
And then who pushed the ball back?
Well, there's so many elements of that length of the field play, wasn't there? Brilliant stuff. Charlie Ngātai, did you see him? He was cruising along, and it's almost like, boom, he just hit the accelerator.
Can you also
superb.
Just check the actions of the blue player?
The skills. Baker, he left it behind.
Yeah, that transfer there between Baker and Tahu Reorangi is what they're going to be looking for here. There's no doubt in my mind that's been touched by a Bay of Plenty hand, and that constitutes a try. Absolutely. It's just that transfer, Nartai to Baker, that's where the big question mark will be. Here we go.
Got it on the ground.
He just holds it up. And Baker looked like he was in front, didn't he, of Tahu Riorangi. So it appeared to have gone back from that angle.
Yeah, I think that's been lost forward, to be honest. This pass here, where Baker touches it, and then Tahu Riorangi gathers it. Right there, that's gone forward. He has to claim it again, Baker, for it not to have gone forward. He's tapped it forward, clearly. Have a look at this, there. If Tahu Riorangi doesn't catch the ball, Baker has to, otherwise it goes forward.
Well, they're not so sure, are they, Willie? They're looking at this several times. I'm not 100% sure. Neither am I, to be honest, but that's why I've gone a bit silent. Gee.
In my view, that is not a try, unfortunately. However, we'll leave that in the capable hands of Grant Wilson, who is the TMO today. Here is the decision.
Yes, Grant. What was that? Sorry, can you repeat that?
No try.
So you're saying knock on black? Thank you. No try.
They've been denied twice.
Well done, Taranaki.
You got it, Willie. Well done. Look at the breakout. Tamari Valu to his partner in crime. Nartai, look at that. That's the acceleration you're talking about, Paul. Love it. Love seeing pace like that.
Oh, the skill level there of these modern day players is superb.
It's the right decision, Matthew Cooper.
Absolutely. When you look at it even from there, you can see that. You picked it there. It was the knock-on into Kurt Baker. And absolutely. So what a breakout and what a scrum back there under the pin from the Taranaki side.
So important, the 10 minutes prior to the break, to score points. And I wonder what Clayton McMillan will say to his troops. They turned down the opportunity to possibly get 3-6 points. And let's not forget that Taranaki still only have 14 players on the field. They squeeze and go over the ball. Hollingshead gets it wide out to Fraser. Now Tiatia says, let's just get out of here. And that's a good touch finder from the left winger. Baker wants to get on with it quickly into Vainu. Breaks through the first tackle. Can't get away, though, from Fraser. They look to come down the short side where Tamari Valu standing again. Breaks through the first. Tamari Valu holding the ball like it's a tennis ball more than a rugby ball. Just with ease, he's starting to find that form that we saw in 2014. As Charlie Nartai now finds some open spaces in behind where the wingers are standing. It's bounced once, twice. Hollingshead gets back. And Fraser said, let's go to a line-out.
And you caught it, Willie. Tommy Valu, he's actually starting to cause havoc out there for the Bay defenders. Every time he's getting the ball, he's beating 3 to 4 players, and they're coming in to commit to him, and it's creating opportunities. Look at this. Great fend. And as you say, he's just teasing them. The ball in one hand. He's obviously got some big lunch hooks on him.
It's great, isn't it? You got him here. And then it's the player inside him as well, in terms of Charlie Nartai. The likes of Ryan Crotty, George Moala. Geez, we're well served, aren't we, for midfielders in New Zealand.
Absolutely blessed. They've walked into most national teams anywhere in the world. Terrific players as Thompson goes high again. So Taranaki looking to try and close that deficit. Nartai carts it forward. Tahu Riorangi, another beautiful delivery up to Ray. Tamari Valu this time finds Ormond flirting with the touchline. Tiatia makes the tackle. He's got all rights to the ball, but he's lost it. Now into Marshall. They come down the blind side again. Tamari Valu getting in closer to the action. Obviously, Colin Cooper's told him he needs to get his hands on the ball, and he's told Angus Tarvel he's got a license to run wherever he likes. He's at first receiver again. Ray, he won't take it because it's gone behind everybody. So plenty of enterprise.
Yeah, I think at the halftime chit-chat, Bay of Blenny coach Clayton McMillan will be talking about targeting the ball. Tommy Vola, who's going to run with the ball like that. The Taranaki players need to target the ball to shut him down. And I noticed earlier in the first half, a lot of ball was, not a lot, but a few balls were spraying from players as they attacked, and because the players were attacking that ball. So that's probably an area that the Bay will be looking to attack.
Just have a look now. They've used those big runners at ball in terms of Tamani Valu, the likes of Charlie Nartai. Jackson Orman is just floating there outside Cody Ray. And this is where you can do a bit of deception. You can just see those two players there. Jackson Orman is a lovely straight runner. And they might try a behind ball to try and slip Orman through the gap.
They'll be delighted that they have withheld Bay of Plenty with only 14 players on the field. And Mitchell Croswell, probably about 2 minutes away from making his way back onto the field. As we look at Jackson Orman standing in behind Cody Ray.
Well, it's easy to forget they've only had 14 players because they've really upped the ante since they lost their man, haven't they?
Scrum has been strong too. Look at the back of Angus Talvo. And eat your breakfast off that as they cart it forward. Ray using the short ball. And we're waiting for him though. Orman comes in and clears it. Tauri Orangi again goes in. Ngātai throws the wide pass out to Vainot. He's got some space here, Vainot. Looked up, thought about kicking it. Held on to the ball. I thought he was out, but he's done brilliantly, the left winger, to stay in play. Tauri Orangi gets it wide. Now the pass into no man's land. Sakalia gets it for Bay of Plenty. And now their opportunity with some players out here on the left. Hollingshead. Few step from Fraser.
No, Chase is still in.
And it's Chase Tiatu who actually kicked the ball.
Carried back.
County's Manukau carried back, so they can't carried kick it back out on the full. Toma knows that. Blue. And so he just kicks it deep to where the number 8 Halaf figure is. He gets it into Charlie Nartai. There's that right boot. And he'll just grubber that ball along the ground, hoping it falls in between the two defenders. Fraser.
Keep coming, five. Stop, five. Yeah.
Hoping that it'll stop about there. No problem with that. We'll come back for the 22 restart. And a little bit of a game of force back between Ngātai and Fraser.
Well, some of the lower numbers won't mind that because it's been pretty frantic pace, hasn't it? They've been working hard, so just a chance to catch the breath as we approach half time.
Great scoreline, isn't it? 6-3.
Anybody think they're playing on a muddy pitch with an old leather rugby ball coach?
Yeah, an old test match as well. As Hollingshead retrieves it and takes the ball to the halfway mark. A nice high up and under. Baker looks interested, comes in and takes it. That's Kurt Baker. Then he looks up and he sees a little bit of space. The former Sevens representative, Ngātai, looked out and they were forwards, and he says, well, I'm not passing there, I'm just going to take it forward myself. They try and hold him up, but he fights his way to the ground, does the Taranaki captain.
Here it is.
Slow ball means that the Bay of Plenty defensive line is set. Now they get it out to Hiata. No problem at all. So Tupe couldn't believe his luck. The ball was sitting there. Toma tried to steal it. And I think that's another penalty against Benny Hall. And he's blown up.
Oh, no. They had the penalty.
Well, he's taken it, Toma, so there is an advantage. Now it's a metallic. Now they've got a full line here. They need to just go straight. Tiatia does just that. The tackle looked a little high from Orman. Dan Baker. But they've still got possession. Toma, now in referee's time, gives it up to Talapitanga. They pick and go through Harris.
No hands!
Here goes Mewat. Just three short. This is where they've really improved their game, and that is Edu. He tries to get one wide. Toma wants the ball. There's no one out to the left-hand side, and so he just says to forwards, you guys take it here. And Metallic does exactly that. They pick and go again. Staunch defence from Taranaki. Toma wants the ball now. Hollingshead has it. They've got some numbers out here of the Bay of Plenty. Here comes Hall. Drawing pass. They could have scored. What does the referee say?
Touch.
It's gone in touch and we'll head to the break. 6-3, two penalties to Dan Hollingshead. And 1-2, Cody Ray for Taranaki. Boy, what a pulsating first 40 minutes of this ITM Cup match between Bay of Plenty and Taranaki. So, just awaiting now
The interview with Matthew Cooper. He's downstairs with Jackson Ormond.
Well, thank you, Willie. Well, Jackson, you've held on there nicely, haven't you?
Yeah, mate, we just need to hold on to the ball when we get down there, stop, cut out our silly mistakes, and I think we'll pull some pressure and probably score some points, so we'll work on that in the second half.
Looking well with the ball in hand, the backs.
Yeah, mate, then again, we just need the ball more and down the right end of the field, and we'll go right, I think.
Thanks, Jackson. Well, it's half-time here at Rotorua International Stadium. Bay of Plenty, the home side in front by 6 points to 3.
Welcome back to the Rotorua International Stadium, where the hosts, Bay of Plenty, are taking on Taranaki. Two penalties to Dan Hollingshead to the single from Cody Ray, but there was plenty to talk about in the opening 40 minutes of this match, Bull Allen, and in particular, the first time where that was a knock-on. If it wasn't, this was a beautiful try.
Yeah, they got it wide. Now down the outside channels, Thompson and Co are deadly. And Nartai, the support play there. While Taranaki was celebrating, we got to watch the TMO replay.
Well, you caught
Croswell.
Right.
Yeah, he knocked it on. I mean, there was a 50-50 call.
And then here, the decision to send a player to the sin bin for 10 minutes. There is the alleged punch from Mitchell Croswell. He didn't agree with the ruling on the field. And Bay of Plenty decided to take the scrum, and then the breakout from Taranaki. Firstly, Tamani Valu into Ngātai, and then they were queuing up. And this pass here, it found the hands of Kurt Baker, and then Tahu Reorangi was deemed to be forward. It was the right decision. They finished it beautifully, but once again, the TMO was called on.
Yeah, absolutely. Could have been a totally different first half of both of these tries rewarded, but the TMO, he's got it right and done a fantastic job. And you just see here, a stat that I'm really surprised by, Willie, is tackles made. Bay of Plenty have been working hard, haven't they? Now, what effect will that have in the second half, and how early will they need to bring on players? Because they're working really, really hard, as opposed to they've almost doubled their output tackling to Taranaki.
At 10 missed tackles from Bay of Plenty, Taranaki's won. Half-time here in the match between these two sides. We'll be back with the second half in just a moment. Side Bay of Plenty ahead by 6 points to 3. Centurion of Bay of Plenty, 117 matches is their coach, Clayton McMillan, and he's downstairs with Matthew Cooper.
Well, Clayton, you're certainly in the scrap, aren't you?
Yes, what we want to do is to bring them into a bit of a dogfight here. You know, they're a dangerous team and been pretty successful at that. We've left a few points out on the park, but a couple of TMO decisions gone our way, so call it evens.
Yeah, I was going to ask you that, about 9 points. How are you about those decisions?
I probably would have taken the last one. Had a bit of momentum going our way, so I'm not going to berate the boys for having a crack. That's what you need to do against the best teams, and didn't come off, but still 40 minutes to make up for it.
Okay, good luck for the second.
Cheers. Yeah, he's a quality coach. There's no doubt about that. Success that Clayton McMillan had with the Wellington under-19s at the Jock Holmes Memorial last year. And Bull, you and him are very much on the same page that they should have taken the points.
Yeah, I think he stated they should have taken the last kick.
But I like the way, so I'm not going to break the boys. They've got to have a go at the best team. So he's encouraging them to have a crack, and I just like his calm demeanour, actually. He's doing a good job.
And what about the confidence of this Taranaki side? They defended for 10 minutes with 14 players. What does that bring to them in the second half?
Oh, they'll be coming in very confident, thinking they're a little bit hard done by, that they didn't get a couple, at least one of those tries. And they've made Bay of Plenty make a lot of tackles, as we saw in the stats at halftime. The question is, how much sting has that taken out of the Bay team?
Ready, Callum? All good.
Taranaki with the start, playing in the dark shorts. And it goes all the way down. Looks like we've got a new player on the field, and that looks like Troy Callender in jersey 19. Carts it forward back into Hollinshead. He gets it along to Tia Tia, that left boot of Chase Tia Tia. They won't kick it out on the full. Halafihi carts the ball forward now. Is into the contact. Tauri Olangi is there. He gets out to Thompson with a little bit of footwork from the big lock. Play it again. Good patient build up. Just getting the ball along the hands and into the hands of Charlie Ngātai.
Play on.
Stolen by Retallick. Tupe runs into the shoulder of Tava. Loses the ball, and Tauri Arangi says, let's kick it there. Jackson Orman with the chase. Inside the 22 of Bay of Plenty, here comes Fraser, Te Rangi Fraser. He was forced to kick it quickly, and my apologies, no changes. I think it was Fuketi who actually took the ball at the start. So the same 15 on for Bay of Plenty as that left.
Oh, good start from Taranaki, just building those phases once again. They look $1 million when they got the ball in hand. They just, their structure is superb. You can see they're very well drilled. Colin Cooper knows how to run a team. He's been doing it a long time. But what they need to do now is put this field position into points.
Rhys Marshall with the throw into Thompson, who climbs high again. They get the ball under control, and it's Benny Hall in the back. Characteristic hairstyle with the headband. Needs his forwards to drive straight. Bay of Plenty try and turn it, and they've impeded. There's a penalty that's going to come the way of the visitors, Taranaki. Hall goes to ground. Tauri Arangi clears it. Ray, wide pass out to Tamani Vala. Another skip pass, perhaps. Baker came in on the short ball looking for some work. Tamani Vala holds on to the ball. Charlie Ngātai couldn't get rid of some of the defenders that were there, and so they'll come back for the penalty.
Well, what'll be interesting is the mindset of Taranaki, because Bay of Plenty had these opportunities in the first half to see what they'll do, if they'll go for the line or go for the shot.
Well, they're stuck in that corner, aren't they, Ball? And let's have a look at what Cody Ray looks as though. Yep, they look as though they're going to back their line out. And this would make a real statement if they got over early after all that endeavour from Bay of Plenty in the first half, missing those 9 points through penalties. Good structure from the Taranaki side. Typical Colin Cooper trademark, that rolling drive there.
Thompson, 2-0. Ricky Hoare, he's 1-2 as well. They go to Thompson again. He climbs high. Benny Hall again in the back, fights his way to get back in the boot. And now they rumble forward. Taranaki denied twice, not three times. Try time for Benny Hall. They rolled the dice. They got the penalty. They drew the line out. Thompson brought it down. And Benny Hall scores his second ITM Cup try.
Oh, that was good stuff. The transfer from Thompson to Hall at the back. Watch this, beautiful, the position of the players in front. Look at the depth of that. It's not wide, it's nice and long and narrow, and they just basically split the Bay forward pack to bits.
Well, there's been a lot of endeavour from the defending champions in the first 40, and they've come up short, couple of TMO decisions against them. But this time they went back to the structure. Great Taranaki forward play, Bernie Hall over for the first try. They've come into the attack zone, and they've taken the points.
What I liked about that, Coops, is Hall had a shoulder firmly on the player in front of his backside. He was down low and driving. A lot of players, they stand at the back of those mauls and they're up high and looking around. Well, he was contributing with his power because he was low and driving at the same time.
Cody Ray with the conversion. He can't add the two. And so 8-6 opening stages of the second half.
Yeah, looks like he's run into a few park buses in his time. Benny Hall.
I used to play with, I played a couple of games for Taranaki with his dad, Peter Hall. Used to play for Inglewood, the champion club when I was playing club rugby in Taranaki. So he's from good stock. His dad was a hard man too.
No, I bet. And it's good reward for Taranaki, and now they can't get their hands on the kickoff. Toma has it, gets it out to Edu. Good run from Sean Edu. Good 20 metres gain from the blindside flanker. Toma clears it now. Retallick standing out at first receiver, gets it back into Toma. Tauriarangi can't make the tackle. Thompson's ineffective there, and they pick and go now. This has woken up the hosts, and Edu again with another carry. Croswell looks interested. He may have stolen the ball, Mitchell Croswell. He has, but the counter-up comes in from Bay of Plenty. This is good play as they rumble forward. Tala Apitanga.
Advantage.
And they're going to get the penalty here. So that's a great reward for Bay of Plenty. After conceding a try, a chance to get back in the lead.
Oh, it was gains of millimetres at a time, but I just loved it. It was very incremental, but just the pick and go, pick and go, pick and go. And what I liked about it, sometimes we can get very sideways when we pick and go. It was just all up through the middle and done very well. And the combos here work so well. Love it. Well, there we see them working hard in there. And that just, as a defensive team, it's hard to get back and get your structure in place when the team is just picking it up so quickly. It gives you no time to reset.
Well, Hollinshead's taken no time to reset either. He has put Bay of Plenty back ahead by 1 point. And Matthew Cooper, frustrating as we look at Hori Bock, but frustrating for a coach after you've scored points to not do the basics from the restart.
Absolutely. So he's gone to the bench already, hasn't he? So Keto's come on for Timer at halfback. And also you've got Leroy Van Dam's coming on for by Mutu Craft Chemist in the Bay of Plenty side.
So Van Dam on in jersey 23 and a change at halfback with John Okito.
Well, that's a good change because Kito plays club rugby with Dan Hollinshead for Te Puke Sports, so they'll have that combo well sorted.
No, there was always breakdown in communication between Van Dam and Fulketti as they go on with it to Taranaki into the hands of Baker Ormond on the halfway mark. Good chase and good tackle. Now they pick and go. Tavo, that offload to Tahu Reorangi. Little halfback pops it and he gives it to Hall. Hall again! Seven short. Here come Taranaki again on the attack. This time it's Graham who had to reach back to actually pull the ball forward. The break initially from Tahu Reorangi is there again. Now they clear it. Second man play with the player in behind. Here goes Ngatai. He's beaten the first defender who was Tiati, who came out of the line, and now Baker has it. Tahu Reorangi has it. There's an advantage here. They'll get the penalty.
No, boys.
Those matches where it's blow for blow.
Who's off the mark?
Yeah, tip for tat, isn't it? I love it, though. It's very entertaining. It's been a wonderful game to watch.
Well, I mentioned to Clayton McMillan at halftime, he said, how do you think you're going? He says, oh, we're in the scrap. And that's exactly what it is, isn't it? It's a real tussle. There's a lot of niggle. It's all fair niggle. But look at the speed here from Tahu Reorangi. You mentioned him, Willie. He's got speed. Doesn't he look a little bit like Aaron Smith there with that lovely little break? And then Bernie Hall, he's shown he's got a few wheels as well.
It's amazing how the speed accelerates when you get the ball in hand, isn't it? You can be cruising along, but when you get the ball, you just, boom, you're away.
Well, they've opted for the line-out as well. They had the option to take the penalty. They want to try and work it again. Thompson is their go-to man. Boyata the other. And they go to Croswell on this occasion. Why change something that isn't broken? Halafihi has the ball, they march it forward. Here comes another try for him. Tora. Halafihi scores Taranaki second, very much like the first. And rolling up and flexing their muscle, really, is the Taranaki side five.
Oh, I just think Bernie Hall's a generous man. He got the first one. He's let his mate Halafihi get this one. But same old story. They just get low, they drive. And on that occasion, Bay of Plenty actually kept themselves together, but they're too high. You see the body position.
Well, it'll make you happy, co-commentator, because that's where you used to do a lot of that at Rugby Park in New Plymouth. and you can call it a stampede or whatever you want. They're called the Bulls, aren't they? The Taranaki Bulls. Over they go.
Oh, it's called pretty to watch. Where we come from, Coops, we love it.
Like a stampede, like a bull rush. And Cody Ray.
And I think we should say, Willie, too, in Bay of Plenty's defence here, that is very hard to stop when it's done well. You know, it's one of the hardest things to stop on the rugby field.
And I'm sure that the All Blacks may be watching this over in the UK. And if you are, best wishes for the upcoming tournament as Cody Ray adds the extras from a difficult position.
Great kick, Cody Ray. He's had a couple. He had one there before, and it was a tough one. That time he got the radar right. Great conversion from the first five.
The restart from Hollingshead.
Hicker Elliott out there too for you. There he is in the Taranaki jersey, Willie Lose.
Yeah,
he's replaced Reece Marshall.
Good to see him out there too, Coops. It's great to have Hicker Elliott on the field. And he would dearly love to get ball in hand. One thing is guaranteed, if they get another 5 metre line out, we know who's going to come around and pinch the ball at the back.
Yeah, the order of the queue will change around a fair bit with Hicker Elliott on there. He likes the tough, dark places, doesn't he?
Eight there for Bay of Plenty and 17-1. So Ziggy's on. Ziggy Fishihoy replaced the Blazer man of 15 games, Solomona Sakalia.
Joe Tupe also replaced for Kainga, Mike Kainga, and they managed to win the ball to Bay of Plenty, but they've got a long way to go. And here comes the Tehangi Fraser. Keeps pumping the legs. Looked on the inside and the ball out the back. The offload. Nata says, I'll take that. I was running back onside. It was general play. And now Tamani Valu picks up the ball and gets an extra 7 metres. So strong. There's the centre from Taranaki, and he's going to get the penalty too.
Tamani, get out of my way. Valu, he's doing some damage. Not content to hang out at centre either. He's getting in there doing the hard yards. I think you're right. I think maybe the Taranaki coaching staff have said, hey, we want to see you get more involved. And he's taken that and run with it. He's causing some havoc.
Well, he's coming in and getting involved, Matt, in at first receiver, and he's so strong.
Well, there he is. There's the defence there. There's the attack from Bay of Plenty. And legally there, he's just coming back into play. Broken play there, Charlie Nato. Yeah, you're right. He's a good footballer, and he just needs more time. Big opportunity for him in the Super Rugby season next year, because he needs to make a statement at that level as well.
Victor Elliott's first throw goes to Thompson. There he is. Now he's got the ball in the back. They've got to use it. Tauri Orangi to Ray. Flatline from Ngātai. The rushing defence as well from Bay of Plenty. They're up very, very quick, and they're interested in trying to steal the ball. Bernie Hall gets his mitts on it, gets rid of Hollingshead, and carts it forward. He's had a good game today, Bernie Hall. Elliott plays halfback into Hoyata. Now out to Thompson. And the tackle of Fisi'ihoi. Ngātai. He's got lovely footwork. That's Charlie Ngātai in the close channels. As they get it out, here goes Elliott. Fresh legs on the field.
Oh, good carry.
And hit it wide again. Gray looks on the inside. Here's Baker. Kurt Baker's through. Kurt Baker will score. The gap just opened up. The pass may have been marginal. I think it was live ball. Angus maybe wants to have a second look at it. But Kurt Baker's line was magnificent.
It was absolutely superb. And this is the third TMO decision. And some of the players down there are not happy that it's going to TMO decision. But it is the right decision. And the missed tackles are really starting to stack up for the Bay now. They've had 12 missed tackles. And that's put down to a very nice line by Baker. Look at this. And Ray, what do you call that? That looks a live ball because it was right on the line.
Yeah, no problem in my view.
Yeah, I'm agreeing with you on that one, Willie. That was superb. But Cody Ray, how good was the pass? Look at him, Baker. Here he is. The timing is absolutely spot on, isn't it?
They're talking about the interference and maybe the line that Blake Thompson had run, but he had no impact on that. This should be the try. Oh, and the celebration's not bad either. Take it, he's loving it.
Grant, I'm happy with that. I'm happy to award the try.
Well, there you go. That's what I like to see from a referee too. Stop waiting for the TMO to tell you. He's had a look at the big screen here, and he says that's line ball, that's try time.
Kurt Baker's there. Was there ever any doubt? Beautiful.
Lovely play from the fullback. Just watching him, he's had a whole lot of problems with hamstrings over the last couple of years. That was a beautiful line. Second half, the fatigue setting in, and the fullback as Cody Ray bangs over the two. That's a very good response after half-time from the Taranaki side. Just watch the inside ball there. And that's a good sign to see Kurt Baker running like that, Willie Lose.
This Taranaki team in the second half looks like a team very much in sync and getting their run right. They started slowly, but they really can just see their confidence growing. And you spoke about it at halftime, Willie. You asked the question, what will their confidence be like after missing a couple of tries? And they're giving us the answer.
They played with 14 players too, remember. And denied twice in the first half. They haven't been denied in the second half, Taranaki, and they're playing the game at the right end of the field, asking questions of Bay of Plenty. Fraser will just let it go over the line. And but look at that, 70% possession for Taranaki. That's a stat, and that's when you've got to get points, when you've got that much dominance. And they certainly have, with the three tries to Hall, Halafihi and Baker. Ray stands deep and gets it into the try scorer. And Kurt Baker, love the way he runs with the ball, always in two hands too. It's a real quality of Kurt Baker. Keeps the defenders guessing, straight down from Tiatia. And Fraser looks up, runs straight into Hall, brings him down. Keto in at halfback to Hollingshead. There's a lovely bit of space there between Cody Ray and the touchline.
Number 19's on, sorry to jump in there. 19's on, Mitchell Brown has replaced number 5, Blake Thompson. So he's come from the field. Missed tackles there, 12 to the Bay of Plenty side. Paul Allen mentioned that in his analysis at halftime. Just the amount of tackling they've had to do is starting to take a bit of its toll on the home team.
And another line out. The high kick. Van Dam is back there, takes it well. As the right winger gets it into Fraser. Like the look of this young man. Not much to him, but we see the quality of fullbacks in this competition. He's another one. Hollingshead grubber, the kick, grubber kicks the ball along. Here's Baker. He'll be taken out into touch.
Clever play there from Dan Hollingshead. Saw the space and off they go again.
Well, they want to get on with it. Yeah, he won't have a problem getting away from the profile, will he? Well, it's Edu again. Van Dam goes in. Keto says get out of the way. And Hollingshead will just grubber it along the ground. Charlie Nartai is in a nice field position. And he kicks it deep over the head of Fraser.
Hold the mark.
It's rolling. It's gone dead. Boy, he hardly hit that, Charlie Nartai. We're going to have to come back some 75 metres, 70 odd metres.
Coming on
the scrum. That's the love of the rugby board. You just never know which way it's going to roll.
Wonderful outcome from Bay of Plenty. They need something to go their way, and it just gives them a bit of time to recoup. Because they're working so hard at the moment, aren't they? There's a big influence on tonight's game. Charlie Nartai, he's the leader of the side, and he leads by the way he plays.
Three tries in 2015, 8 clean breaks, and 22 defenders. He has beaten some stats for Charlie Nartai ahead of this match. Hicker Elliott, all the experience of 100 Super Rugby games. His time with numerous ITM Cup sides, as well as the All Blacks, the New Zealand Māori All Blacks.
Stand up.
And what a player he has been, Bull Allen, for New Zealand in the respected game, respected provinces.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Hicker Elliott. I have been for a long time. There's been a bit of chit-chat about things off the field, but I don't buy into any of that. I judge people on what I see on the field, and I admire his courage and the way he's come back. He'd be a handy man to know, too, because he'd have a bit of kit over the years, you know, depending on what team you like to support.
Almost had as many clubs as Matthew Cooper.
One in Hamilton, very proud Hamilton Marist man. Had a couple in the bay.
So who has the right, Matthew? There's a, obviously the Radfilly Shield match between Bay of Plenty and Hawke's Bay.
I'm not sure who won at the moment, but whoever wins has the right, the so-called right to call themselves the Bay, although both provinces would argue that. Should be a good one, Willie, next week.
Yeah, looking forward to it. And John Okito gets a little bit of attention. Straight down. Well, Tahu Rio, don't you? They seem to have a little competition between the two nines, don't they? There's something about little halfbacks who seem to have a game within a game.
Oh, I remember one training when I was a young fella, a halfback throwing mud into my face. At training. They're cheeky buggers, those halfbacks. But Tahu Ringarangi, he's, as we mentioned earlier, from Rotorua Boys High School, gone down to Taranaki, under-20s player. Man, he's having a season, isn't he?
New Zealand's first game at the Rugby World Cup against Argentina, 3:45 on the 21st, as we look at Hohepa Te Toiroa. Tahu Ringarangi.
I like his hairstyle too, Willie, eh? Something that you and I can't achieve.
No, no way. He's a young man, he's only 20. Should have lots of hair.
Yeah, yeah.
That's right.
I'll stay up, collecting.
Well, we haven't had a lot of scrums tonight. That's for sure. And that's, the game's been very accurate, hasn't it? That's what I like about it. It's just been free-flowing, and I'm going to give Angus maybe a bit of a plug here. He's done a wonderful job. His communication's been very good.
Couple of changes, two guys coming on for Taranaki. David Orman on at halfback for Tuhira Rangi. Had a very good game there. Sean Wainui, the New Zealand Māori player, he comes on for number 14, Jackson Orman. We've got Nick Evermy coming on as well for Bay of Plenty, the home team, replacing number 10, Dan Tollinghead. And that's about it. I think we've had a pretty much just about the best. Look at Nathan Harris, he's also come off too for Joe Royal.
Yeah, well, it's the two New Zealand Māori hookers on the field now, Hicker Elliott and Joe Royal.
They had a bit of a powwow too. Joe Royal brings an intensity to the game. He's all about the business.
Taranaki have the ball. And off the back goes one of the try scorers in Halafihi. And to clear it quickly is Ormrod. His first touch of the ball there. Good second pass as well. Here's Tamani Valu. Gets it out to Elliott. Lovely inside ball to Hoyata. They keep it alive down this short side. And Halafihi, he started it. There's the ball again. They crash forward. Just one-off runners now. Fisiewoi can't get his hands on the ball, but they look interested to the Bay of Plenty. Ormrod gets it wide, and they come down the short channel. Again, it's cleared. More front foot ball, and over the advantage line, the back Swanet. As Reyes gives it to Ngātai. He gives it to Croswell, standing out wide. They go the same way again. It's Baker who throws the dummy. But Talak holds on to him only just, and they've lost the ball forward there. No advantage, so they'll come back forward. The penalty, the high tackle perhaps.
Well,
they want to get the bonus point try, surely.
Well, they're in a battle with Waikato, aren't they? The other two, three teams, Tasman, Canterbury and Auckland, are just starting to get a bit of daylight between the fourth team, Willie, which currently is Waikato on 15 points. And Taranaki on 13. So they'll be looking for that bonus because those two teams battle it out at New Plymouth next Friday night.
Well, interesting decision when they've got a roll on. As we can see, the infringement of the high tackle from Metallic, they decide to take the points.
Yeah, no, it is an interesting decision, but I think that's a bit of respect for the Bay of Plenty team, actually, from Taranaki. They can strike at any time, Bay of Plenty. I wouldn't be writing them off just yet. So I like that. I think that's a wise decision.
Cody Ray, good contact. And another 3 points for Cody Ray. He brings up 54 the season.
Talapatangi, prop forward, tight head prop, being replaced now by Mike Kainga for the home side.
And having heard the premiership when Manawatua down the bottom, talk about Taranaki in that position, very close to Waikato and Auckland.
Hold on.
There's Nick Evermy. Looks on and...
come back on.
Here is the restart. So 16 point difference as Baker comes in to take the kick off. That's the 22 line of Taranaki. You can see Ormrod gets his hands on the ball. Lovely little inside pass, and now they just start taking route one straight up the middle. He's in the big concrete mixers, and then the boot of Charlie Nartai. He kicks it down to where Fraser is and to Evermeet. He's got Van Dam out to his right. Van Dam likes to run through the dummy pass. That's a good carry from Leroy Van Dam. Slow ball though. Means that they now get it wide, and Fraser looked up, and then he got tackled by Hall. The counter-ruck comes in from Taranaki, but Keto gets in and clears it quickly. Here goes Royal. Joe Royal hits, turns, and there is Evermy again, the dummy. Can't get past the tackle of Halafili. Now it's been stolen by Ray. The offload to Hoyata. They say one way and then the other, and Onward finally gets the call. Running up out of the line was Elliott, and then Ngātai grubbers it along the ground and says, let's go to a line-out. Good, intelligent play from the Taranaki captain.
Oh, good play. Nice, balanced play from the second five and captain of Taranaki.
Six blue sub.
Well, that was astute, wasn't it? He saw the rush defence coming up, and he couldn't find any way through, so kept it through. There we see Hawke's Bay. Gee, they're having a stellar season, aren't they? And Wellington had their first loss of the season, but of course playing against Tasman last night. Gee, they are quality.
Sensiatanga number 20 for Bay of Plenty. He's replaced number 6, blindside, Sean Edel.
Joe Royal with his first throw finds Mewitt. Sakito running ball again for Hall, but he's held up. Chalinyato's done very well to hold him up. This will be a turnover. We spoke about his class of finding play and grubber kicking, and that's just another sign of what he has in his skill set.
Oh, and you just see the players rallying around him too. You can see how much he means to the team, but here's Hall. Ray, Nartai and Hall from the Taranaki team defending very well. So it's Hall on Hall. But yeah, 3-on-1. Usually the ones are going to lose that one. But good defence from Taranaki. They've really picked up the tempo.
Well, they have. They started slowly, Bull, didn't they, in this competition, the defending champions. But they're just starting halfway through, just playing a lot of smart rugby. Those two tries they needed. Slow start this afternoon or this evening. Two really good tries, but it's that physical approach without the ball what's really impressive of last year's champions.
Well, there's plenty of rugby for you to enjoy as well. Up next is Canterbury against Hawke's Bay. Hawke's Bay unbeaten in the championship. Canterbury on top as well with Tasman. And then tomorrow from the Garden of Eden, Eden Park, 2:30 is Auckland against Otago. And the final match of this round robin sees Manawatu host Northland at the Arena Stadium in Palmerston North. Good attacking opportunity here for Taranaki. Midfield scrum.
Set. All sixes, yeah? Let's keep
often the case.
And let's keep the stability.
With the changes.
Yeah, good to see Mike Kainga back. He hasn't played much rugby this year. He's had some injury problems. The replacement tight head prop with Bay of Plenty. He was a big part of the Bay team last year. He's a Māori player. Brings a lot of experience for such a young man.
And there are the backs with Cody Ray standing directly behind the scrum. There is Kurt Baker out to the right, but they've got a scrummage first, and they've done that. Fisiahi. Halafihi, rather. Went to try and grab at the ball, and he's lost it forward, so...
Not now.
They'll be celebrating Bay of Plenty. They'll love that.
Ziggy Fishy Hoy. They're celebrating and giving him a big smack on the back and the head, because it's a loosehead side that did the damage. You can see him coming up there, just demoing that Taranaki scrum.
Number 8 and try scorer for the visitors. Tour. Halafihi scored the second try from that line-out drive, being replaced by number 20, Lachlan Boshier.
Oh, there's a great front row debate going on out there, isn't there? What do they talk about props anyway? Oh, look, Willie, you didn't play on the front row, so there's no point in me starting because you wouldn't understand.
They probably spend about a half an hour talking about that scrum, Willie.
Exactly.
You guys, look, honestly, I don't want to criticise your IQ, but you just wouldn't get it.
Keto with the feed. Now they've got some running ball. Here goes, Keto. You hear it through the graphics or the sound, rather. No, go, Keto. And he did too, but he's held on to it. Thought he may have got isolated, and now Tia Tia. There's the ball.
20.
Josh Honick. Sorry, Zach Honick, just telling him to, got the wrong Honick there. Just telling him to settle down, just calm down.
Yeah, a bit of a chest pumping going on. Oh, Kiddo, he's quality guy, this. I've watched him play a bit of club rugby this year. He knows how to make those breaks. Very smart player. Well, it was a big dogfight in there. Could have gone either way, but Bay of Plenty, they move it off the line out.
And they've got it through Evermeet. Out to that man, Honick. After being peacemaker, comes Setter. The loop around to Keto. He gets the shoulder of Leah. And now they pick and go. Fisihoi is there. Whirls over the top. Keto wants it. Slow ball, though, out to the locks now. The pairing of Mewitt out to Vitalik's captain. Again, someone else puts their hand up, and this time it's Kainga. In looking for the steal is Taranaki. They've won it cleanly. And they've won the penalty through Sione Lea.
Well, he questioned that he was on his feet. He said he was okay, referee maybe. I thought he might have been challenged there in terms of falling away, not holding that... that body position. But I would say from Bay of Plenty side there, Bill, what a great impact from the replacements. About every one of those plays there, it was all the new replacements coming on, so they're adding value.
Exactly what you want from your bench, just getting involved. And here we see Kainga, he takes it in, and he was, well, there was enough Bay of Plenty players there, but the Taranaki player doing a good job, just good body position. He got in very quickly and early, and he's strong of stature, and he held his ground.
Now we stand to look at the clock and realise that they're one try away from a bonus point. Those bonus points are so crucial in this competition. As the ball now just bounces into no man's land. Bernie Hall claims it. Ormrod gets it out, and now Baker. Just ask questions of Tia Tia, Chase Tia Tia. In the midfield is Fraser. Fraser, they came up quickly on him, and Fraser gets away from the first. Can't get away from the second. Yes, he does. Buys a little bit of time, which allows the forwards to get there in support. Keto Evermi stands deep in the pocket. He wants it, and he wants to unleash it as well. Honick gets it a little bit wider. Now they take it up through Siatonga. And Metallica, a lovely little pop pass there. That's the 10-meter mark you can see inside the Bay of Plenty half. Here goes Hall. Hall with a trademark run. Top pass on the inside. Couldn't be taken by Wall. But they were building phases nicely.
Yeah, Hall did very well to break the line here. Nice dummy in the fend of Elliott. And oh, yeah, that was unfortunate. There was a bit of wide open space. But Wall wasn't expecting that one. And it happens. Handling errors there, you see it. Bay of 27. Taranaki 9.
Well, most of those were early in the game, weren't they? There's been a couple in the second half, but generally from that, the quality's been very good.
16 points the difference. 6-3 at half time, and the three tries have come in the second half after two were denied in the first. Hall, Halafihi, and Baker. Three try scorers for Taranaki. Now into that last 10 minutes of the match. Can they get the bonus point try as Ormrod feeds it? Now the pressure comes on from Bay of Plenty. They screw the scrum around. And here goes Avaimu. Good tackle from Van Damme that had to be made. Cleared again. Here goes Leah. Lay some running ball, a low pass, which Ngātai had to take from the ground, and now they come running through. Baker looks interested. Baker, Chase Teatea had to come from the right wing. Taranaki looking dangerous again, and they're in that formidable position, which is the 5-metre line of the Bay of Plenty try line.
Well, you just see the urgency from Baker there. Clever little kick through, and Baker just guessed it. And it's that man Ngātai again.
Yeah, who's the kick again? Yeah, you're dead right. Charlie Ngātai just controlling things on the screen.
He does it all.
Well, here's my prediction. It won't come out of the lineouts. And Hicker Elliott scores. So they've done the first part. And there is Elliott in the back. In the boot, they're going backwards though. So great defense from Bay of Plenty. That's brilliant. Hall has it. Ormrod says give it. And now Ray, Cody Ray, almost through the tackle of Fraser. Going full short. Fraser's got to roll away from there. Ormrod has it. Out to Tamanivalu. Big and strong. He's a two. Too strong. We've been waiting for this to happen. And Tamanivalu gets the bonus point try. Shows his class yet again. So hard to stop as this man on screen.
Yes, you know what's going to happen, but it's still a matter of stopping the big unit. Oh, he's had a tremendous game. Good work from Bay initially at the line out. Ray does a great job here. He makes another 8 to 10 metres he shouldn't have made. They should have pulled him down earlier than that, the Bay. And then Tommy Manalavalu, can't even say it, I'm so excited about it, does a great job.
Oh, he does. He's a good stepper, isn't he? We know that. He's powerful. He's a big stepper. Just needs that confidence, ball in hand. Let him play what's in front of him. Don't get too tricky in the way that they play game plans. I like him. I think he's a very good footballer. The star of the show last year in 2014. Just giving us a glimpse tonight, Willie. And this guy had a lot to do with it too. Cody Ray's had a good night with the boot as well.
Yeah. Poor old Caleb Hall looked up, and it was Tamanivalu in front of him as Ray adds the extra 2 points. But once they got it wide, have a look at this. It's Hall against Tamanivalu. No contest. Straight through. Very little that Keto could do. That is 5 points.
Liam McBride, I think that might be the rest end of the night for Cody Ray, and it is. He's had a good game, so we've got a change in there for Liam McBride.
And then he got two back replacements. Now they had Ormrod, but McBride comes on. Wainu hasn't been there, and now they play it though. Didn't go to Tian Tavo, knocked it on. So two knock-ons mean we'll go back for the first. Can Bay of Plenty respond?
Well, Bay of Plenty of a team this year that have really improved their fight. I think what's been good for them this year, Clayton McMillan, he's played, I think you mentioned 113 odd games before the game, Willie. He's been there, done it, and he's instilled a real pride in the Bay jersey. And there's been a lot of big games for them this year, just in their attitude.
A win against Harbour, then they lost to Tasman, they won against Southland, they lost against Waikato, they beat Counties Manukau, and they will lose against Taranaki. So that win-loss sequence happens. Again, as for Taranaki, where they lost the first three after winning 2014, they've gone back-to-back wins, and they'll reach to the third as Van Dam goes running across the field. Teatea gets it out to Fraser, steps on the inside, then on the outside. Teatea again stays in support. And Taranaki used the sideline as an extra defender.
Lost forward by who?
Yeah, they ran out of space here, didn't they, Coops? They're pushing it wide, some nice interplay here. Fraser, he didn't have any room to work with, and they tried to keep it in. Teatea couldn't hold. A credit to the Taranaki defence, as you say, using that sideline is a big help.
Are you half? Step out.
Line out's worked well for Taranaki tonight. Hoyata's 4-0, Thompson 4-0, and they've won another one. There's Ormrod, sends it to the high. Rotorua Sky. Fraser, who started at fullback, has moved to the left wing, gets it into Teatea. Here's Van Dam. Hall with another trademark tackle. There is Evermeet. A kick ahead for Fraser to chase. Baker is back there, though. He's got plenty of time as he looks up, sees the fullback, and sees that there's some space back there. But waiting back has been Evermy. Brings it to the line. There's Evermy and a lovely little offload there, too. Callender now out to Royal. Joe Royal. There goes Big Joe. Look to counter rock. There was no clear release. They'll tap and go. Here's Kito. He wants to get on with the game. So Bay of Plenty finishing with a wet sail. Here is Callender gets the ball again. See, Tonga gets it. Now they get it out to the midfield where Newitt unfortunately can't handle it. And Taranaki will look to counter attack. No, they won't. Tomani Vali says, let's go for field position.
Advantage is over.
And the advantage is over, but that's a great net gain for Taranaki. What a kick from Tomani Vali.
We don't expect to see that, do we? But a great option. Saw the space out wide as the Bay take it quickly through Tiatia.
And he throws the ball across his post to Evermy. They get it out to Hall. Caleb Hall. He's got Hall. It's Hall against Hall. Caleb up against Bernie. Off the foot. And so play on. Geez, the reserves certainly want to get their hands on the ball here. Sending the message to Clayton McMillan. They want the starting spot in the Shield Challenge as Retallick offloads here, and here comes the big man through the middle. Fisioi gets it out to Honick. Honick passes it back on the infield now to Kainga. Slow ball.
Tackle's got to roll first.
Well, great to see the men with the small numbers.
Number 21.
On their back, they're big numbers now, but getting involved in the play.
Oh, adding some real spark, the replacements from the Bay team. And as you say, there's a massive cherry available until the next week against Hawke's Bay for a Shield Challenge. But, boy, they've added some energy, haven't they, these Bay replacements? As Evermy goes for a bit of field position, and he's, well, he's done a great job with that one.
No, that's awful. And, Matt, it all started way back in their own in-goal area with Chase Tiatia.
Absolutely, that quick throw in there. But then also you mentioned about people adding weight and in value. Ziggy Fisioi, the prop forward that's come on, doing a great job there up front, ball in hand.
I'm not surprised at all by that, Coots. But I would say very impressed with the second half performance from Taranaki.
Just really showed, flexed their muscle, and just starting to build nicely into the ITM Cup for 2015, Taranaki.
Well, they've lost two matches against championship teams. They're in the premiership, obviously. They lost to Wellington, they lost to Otago, and that was a hard pill to swallow, considering they were leading so much of that game in atrocious and trying conditions, I think the word is. And they were lucky, not lucky, they thrashed Northland, not luck there, 50-7, but that was one of the championship teams that they've had success, and now success here against Bay of Plenty. So 50% success rate against championship teams is a result that I'm sure Colin Cooper wasn't expecting at the start of this year.
No, it's amazing how things never come the way you think they are going to at times. But Colin Cooper, one of his real attributes is he's very calm. He doesn't get flustered. He's always very measured in his approach to the game, to his players. And he said to me, I said, Coops, you've been doing this for so long. He said, I love it. They become like my family, these guys. I just love them and really enjoy seeing them develop and grow. And that's his attitude. And that's why he brings the best out in these young men.
They have repaid him in spades with their second half performance. They have Taranaki as Baker looks to kick to that corner again. They spent a lot of time down there, and that's quality. That is a great kick from Kurt Baker. You don't get too many better than that, Matt Cooper.
Oh, he's another player too that, you know, as we mentioned, been off the scene for a while. And there we go, the big
Hail Mary, I think
Hail
they call
Mary,
it.
Hail Mary, gridiron, whatever you want to call it. She was a big one, half the field, but knock on there, look out. Here comes the Taranaki side.
Exactly, forget about the train Hain or the Hain train with the 49ers. That won't get him a contract with San Francisco. But boy, you've got to stay attentive when you're playing against Bay of Plenty.
Well, you were just about to grab a lolly, Willie Winch, and you had to throw that back in the packet and get back to your job. Yeah, no, it's been good. It's been good.
Another wine gum saved. There it is. The siren. Which means we're in referee's time, and Taranaki will look to try and score their fifth try of the match. Denied two in the first half. through the TMO, who got it right, I might add, on both accounts. And they've scored four tries, and now they look to try and get their fifth. Ormerod gets it out to Baker. Baker will take it to the line. Takes on for Kitty. And they slip. And it is Sean Wainui, another member of the under-20 side that won the Rugby World Championship. Tarvel gets it out the back around the corner. Lost it forward, though.
Knock on.
And that will be time. Taranaki get the job done. Four tries in the second half after trailing 6-3 at the break. And here at the Rotorua International Stadium, full-time Taranaki 32, Bay of Plenty 9. A masterful performance from the visitors, Taranaki, and getting the job done here with 4 second-half tries to Hall, Halafihi, Baker, Tamanivalu, and the accurate boot off Cody Ray certainly proved to be the difference. 32-9, and a very happy captain, Charlie Ngata, is downstairs with Matthew Cooper.
Well, Charlie, tough game at Rotorua, but a very good second half.
Yeah, we're a bit rusty in that first half. The boys were a bit quiet. Our skill set again sort of let us down. We got the word at halftime, and boys put a good performance in that second half.
You didn't you just kept it nice and tight, particularly with those two line-out drive fries.
Yeah, once we got that first one, the boys wanted another one, so we gave it to them. So that's good for us. So we can use that drive next week against Waikato.
You played very well yourself, and I know you don't like talking about yourself, but just to talk about a couple of other players, Tamanivalu and Kurt Baker at the back, good to see them in good form tonight.
Yeah, Seth's sort of been struggling those first couple of weeks, I think just getting a feel for the game plan, but he played well tonight as well as Kurt, so they're finding their form, which is good for us.
Building nicely?
Yeah, it is. I know we've got sort of tough few games coming up, Waikato, Manawatu, Canterbury, and they're not easy, so we've got to be on our game for that.
Enjoy a few days off, and we'll see you in New Plymouth.
Cheers.
Quality captain, and he certainly showed his class to Charlie Ngatai. Those are the results thus far. North Harbour in a great game against Canis Manukau, 28-20, and then Taranaki getting the job done here at the Rotorua International Stadium, and they will retain the Peter Burke Trophy that has been contested so vigorously between these two sides. And, of course, Canterbury take on Hawke's Bay. And tomorrow, a couple of games for you as well. Auckland taking on Otago at Eden Park. And then, of course, there's Manawatu against Northland at 4:30. Thanks for your company from the entire Sky Sports team. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
The 2015 ITM Cup was proudly brought to you by the Tui Brewery.